The ancient and timeless Greek culture enlightens all Greeks and the whole world. A special part of this world, and Hellenism, consists of the proud and worthy Evrytanians.
Evrytania, rough, wild, a wellspring is the Evrytanian land. Forests, gorges, villages hanging from the hillsides. Sometimes peacefully and other times furiously, creeks gurgle in the valleys, and everywhere, thousand colors from countless varieties of trees and plants, always under the domination of the fir tree. Wherever you look, a different image arises. Every shape, a different light. Every slope, every resting moment, another release of the soul.
The natural characteristics of Evrytania's environment gave its inhabitants, wherever they are, traits such as strength, pride, readiness, a constant willingness to fight, and of course, a contempt of death. This land has a long history reaching into the deep haze of myths and legends. The Evrytanians fought on Achilles' side in the Trojan War. Evrytania appears constantly in the history of Greece throughout its evolution. The role and contribution of Evrytania to the national liberation struggle of the Greeks against the Turks was particularly significant with the formation of the first nation-state in Europe with the Revolution of 1821.
It is our duty to mention the names of the heroes: Ευγενίος Γιαννούλης of Aetolia, Αναστάσιος Γόρδιος Κατσαντώνης, Θανάσης Καρπενισιώτης, Γεώργιος Καραϊσκάκης, Κώστας Βελής, Μάρκος Μπότσαρης, and also Ευγένιος and Dionysios from the school of Φουρνά.
The contribution of the Evrytanians was equally important in the Epic of 40, when Greece stood up against the Italian-German axis during World War II, and also in the national resistance that followed, during which the Evrytanian land and the Evrytanians were at the center of developments. Evrytania, imposing with a charm that is constantly renewed. Wild and untamed, but also sweet and melancholic, it hides inside all the happiness and pain of mankind with dignity and simplicity. One of the greatest sorrows of this homeland was, and still remains, immigration. Even under the Turkish rule, the proud and creative Evrytanians managed to solve their various problems mainly by resorting to Constantinople to make money and support the wives and children who remained behind.
Later in the 35-year period from 1890 to 1924, when about 500,000 Greeks emigrated mainly to America, many of them were from Evrytania. But the most decisive period for Evrytania was the period between 1940 and 1970. The migration of this period hit the Greek mountainous region in a particularly cruel way. The economic impasse, unemployment, social exclusions, the wounds of war, and especially of the civil war, forced young men and women, the soul and hope of the Evrytanian land, to migrate.
Despite the tragic character of the term immigration, and the socio-psychological problems relating to those who leave and those who stay, Evrytanians, with their progressive and rough character, their brilliance and ability for economic development and social dignity, not only survived in their new homelands, but also succeeded in political, academic, and scientific fields, as well as in the business world and at freelance professions.
When researching the records, we observed that the main characteristic of the Evrytanians' immigration to the USA is that about 60% of all immigrants reached America during the period of 1950 to 1970. The number was also significant during the 20-year period of 1930 to 1950.
Βασικά οι Ευρυτάνες πήγανε στην Αμερική, όλοι βέβαια φτωχοί δεν είχαν τότε οικονομική ευχέρεια, γι' αυτό βέβαια και αναζητήσανε και καλύτερη μοίρα. Βρεθήκανε στην Αμερική, αλλά δεν ξεχάσανε ότι αφήσανε πίσω ανθρώπους οι οποίοι δεν είχαν ιατρική περίθαλψη, δεν είχαν μόρφωση, οπότε αρχίσαν αμέσως ενέργειες να βοηθήσουν την πατρίδα.
Ανάθεμα σε ξενίτια. Καταραμένη να σε. Μας παίρνεις τους λεβέντες μας, μανούλες δε.
The regions and villages with proportionately the largest outflow to the USA are Klafsio, Klafsi, East and West Frangista, Fidakia, Marathias, Kalesmeno, Kerasochori, Viniani, Karpenisi, Agia Vlacherna, Domiani, Mozilo, and Agios Andreas. About 50% of the immigrants went to North Carolina, and particularly Charlotte. Other areas where Evrytanians settled were Virginia, followed by Tennessee, New York, Atlanta, Chicago, Boston, and Washington, D.C. Evrytanian groups and associations exist in all areas of Greece, but most of them are abroad, in America, Canada, Australia, and Germany, with leading collective representation provided by the famous Evrytanian Association of America, Velouchi, renowned and by far the first of all associations for its social work.
The president of the association, Mr. Ioannis Peslis, and public relations president, Mr. Nikos Apostolopoulos, will address a brief greeting during the presentation.
Ως πρόεδρος της Ένωσης και εκ μέρους του Διοικητικού Συμβουλίου, θέλω να στείλω χαιρετισμούς σε όλους σας και να σας ευχαριστήσω που είσαστε μέλη. Επίσης, θέλω να επισημάνω το αξιόλογο έργο το οποίο εκτελεί η Ένωση και γι' αυτό πρέπει να θυμόμαστε και να ευχαριστούμε όλοι τους προτεργάτες. Τώρα όμως είναι σειρά της νεολαίας και πρέπει να τους τραβήξουμε ούτως ώστε να μπορέσουμε να αντιμετωπίσουμε ό,τι φέρει το μέλλον προς την Ένωσή μας. Γι' αυτό επίσης θέλω να ευχαριστήσω και την Επιτροπή Δημοσίων Σχέσεων που έκανε αυτό το έργο, το ωραίο DVD.
Αγαπητοί συμπατριώτες, μέλη και φίλοι της Ένωσης, εκ μέρους της Επιτροπής Δημοσίων Σχέσεων σας καλωσορίζω με ιδιαίτερη χαρά στην παρουσίαση του παρόντος ντοκιματέρ με την ιστορία της Ένωσης. Το περιεχόμενό του, κατά κύριον λόγο, είναι έργο της Επιτροπής. Εννοείται ότι η παρουσίαση είναι περιεκτική και οπωσδήποτε ευχάριστη. Στη συνέχεια θα αναφερθούν τα επιτεύγματα της Ένωσης. Όσον αφορά που οφείλονται αυτά, έχω την τιμή να καταθέσω τα εξής. Οι βασικότεροι παράγοντες για αυτό το σημαντικό έργο είναι πρώτον η αγάπη για τον συνάνθρωπο. Δεύτερον, η αγάπη για την ιδιαίτερη πατρίδα μας, την Ευρυτανία. Και τρίτον, η ενότητα μεταξύ των μελών της Ένωσης. Το ότι παραμείναμε ενωμένοι και δυνατοί επί τόσα χρόνια, παρά τις οποιασδήποτε διαφορές μας, είναι μέγιστο γεγονός. Επίσης, κρίνω σκόπιμο να επισημάνω ότι η αγαστή συνεργασία, η ενεργό συμμετοχή και η ηθική και υλική συνεισφορά των μελών της Ένωσης συνέβαλαν και συμβάλλουν στην κάθε επιτυχία της. Κλείνοντας με τις καλύτερες ευχές μας σε όλους τους Ευρετάνες και γενικότερα στους φίλους μας.
It is our sacred duty towards future generations to preserve in a documentary the glorious history of the Evrytanian Association of America Velouchi. These 70 years of action and the association's significant and original work also show the creative development of the Evrytanians of America. Let this be a memorial in memory of our compatriots we lost but never forgot, a legacy to future generations, and a minimum praise to all Evrytanians for their active contribution to the common purpose of the association. Glory and honor to all those pioneers and all the others who struggled and who are still struggling to keep the homeland's communication bridge alive. But above all, it is our duty to preserve the development of the Evrytanians of America, since they are part of the glorious history of Greek diaspora. A history enclosing superhuman efforts and gigantic work.
The success of the Evrytanian immigrants, who have gained an enviable position in American society, universally recognized in both homelands, is the reward for their uncompromising struggle. With this documentary, we tried to record, with great respect, the great love with which the Evrytanians of America consistently offered their help and friendliness to their homeland and their compatriots.
To the first, we owe our birth and our cultural heritage, and to the second, our survival and creative work. Living in America and thinking of our homeland every day is not just a habit. It is a personal experience, an experience which often causes great emotion. Evrytanian immigrants who came to America are not just hunting dreams and prosperity. They are proud and worthy patriots at a time when patriotism is seen as a rather outdated idea. Despite the difficult and harsh conditions they encountered at first, they not only managed to adapt to their new environment, but also they preserved their language, culture, national and religious traditions, their history and customs. They passed down to their children and grandchildren those values and virtues which strengthened the institution of family and creatively reinforced societies. Evrytanians not only survived, but they also managed to stand out and dominate in the fields of business, science, and politics. Beside good patriots, they also proved to be great American citizens. They quickly gained a sense of respect for the laws and social norms of their new land. They easily adjusted to the country's system and the new way of living.
A national association with 18 chapters in America, Velouchi and its hundreds of members offer, sometimes in a private and selfless way, their valuable services to their communities and to American society in general. They contribute financially to the building of churches, Greek schools, and communities. In many different ways, they support various cultural, social, and national events, as well as the sports activities of our youth, of whom the association is particularly proud. The 23rd of October 1944 is a historic day for the Evrytanians of America. The founders of the association held their first meeting at the house of the Evrytanian veteran Thomas Cavallaris in the city of Charlotte in North Carolina. Their goal was to help in every possible way their homeland and their compatriots they deeply loved, and also to contribute to the organization and development of the Evrytanians in America. At this meeting, The historic decision to establish the Evrytanian Association of America, Velouchi, was made, the first convention of which would be held a few months later in 1945, with the participation of 136 members. The important decision to build a hospital in Karpenisi would also be made at this convention. Unfortunately, in the wake of the war, civil war broke out, costing many lives. This development didn't weaken the resolve of the Evrytanian immigrants, but rather it made them stronger and their help towards their homeland even more efficient.
The pioneers who were present at the first meeting of the Evrytanian Association of America Velouchi on October 23, 1944 were the following: Father Georgios Stefanis, Thomas Cavallaris, Konstantinos Alataris, Spiridon Athanasopoulos, Angelos Bakis, Georgios Babalis, Nicolas Drouzos, Georgios Tsoumas, Georgios Galis, Demosthenis Karagounis, Leonidas Kelesis, Ioannis Komatas, Αθανάσιος Κοτσόνης, Δημήτριος Πανόπουλος, Αθανάσιος Μπακατσιάς, Κωνσταντίνος Κοντονίκας, Παναγιώτης Παπακώστας, Γεώργιος Θεόκλητος, Κωνσταντίνος Τσιτούρης, Γεώργιος Χατζόπουλος και Χάρης Γούλας.
The Evrytanian Association of America, Velouchi, is governed under its original constitution, drafted by its founders. The articles of the Constitution were revised and drafted occasionally by Pavlos Chrysikos, Spiros Skenderis, Xenophon Nikopoulos, Christos Moutos, and Dimitrios Poulizos. The Board of Trustees, which is elected every 2 years during the General Assembly of the Annual General Meeting, constitutes the Executive Committee of the Association. It consists of the President, the First and Second Vice President, First and Second Secretary, the First and Second Treasurer, and one representative from each chapter of the association. The chapters of the association are governed in the same way.
Beside those of Evrytanian descent, the association also appoints as equal members friends of the Evrytanians who appreciate the association's work and who are driven by the same ideals while embracing the customs and traditions of our land.
With me today, Mrs. Cindy Kolevas. Mrs. Kolevas, how do you feel being an American married to a native Evrytanian, and what motivated you to become an active Velouchi member?
I married Kosto Kolevas from Muzilo, Evrytania, back in 1987, and we have a happy family with four children who are lifetime members and eager to visit their father's horio every year. We are proud to be members of the historic Velouchi Association, and we look forward to the annual conventions and wish the association the best.
The objectives introduced by the association were and still are philanthropic, patriotic, educational, cultural, and social. Over the years, in order to fulfill more specific needs arising from the extended activity of the association, the auxiliary societies, Daughters of Evrytania, the chapters of the association in America and the Evrytanian youth were established.
Ναι, ο σύλλογος έχει αλλάξει. Έχουν περάσει 70 χρόνια. Η μετανάστευση από την Ευρυτανία τελείωσε τη δεκαετία του 1970 και έχουμε σήμερα δευτέρας και τρίτης γενεάς Ευρυτάνες, μερικοί που δεν έχουν πατήσει στο χώμα της Ευρυτανίας. Δουλεύουμε, είμαστε οργανωμένοι και για αυτούς τους σκοπούς θα συνεχίσουμε το σύλλογο με την νεολαία να κάνουμε το καλύτερο που μπορούμε για τους σκοπούς που είχε ιδρυθεί ο σύλλογός μας και που δουλέψανε τόσο σκληρά πολλοί Ευρυτάνες το καιρό που δεν είχαν τις ευκαιρίες και τις δυνάμεις που έχουμε εμείς σήμερα. Να είμαστε πάντα καλά και ο σύλλογος των Ευρυτάνων της Ευρυτανίας όχι μόνο άλλο 70 χρόνια στο μέλλον θα κρατήσει όσο έχει κρατήσει η ιστορία της Ευρυτανίας, θα κρατήσει και άλλο τόσο στο μέλλον όσο υπάρχει ευρυτανικό αίμα.
The Daughters of Evrytania were first organized on July 4, 1947, with Zoe Cavallari as president, with the main objective to help Evrytania's primary schools, a plan that still exists today. In order to finance this plan, as well as other initiatives, the Daughters of America held their first dance on January 22, 1950 at the Fire Station in Charlotte, a tradition which has continued for more than 60 years. In 1951, the daughters sent care packages to 17 Evrytanian soldiers fighting in Korea, and in 1952, they sent Christmas packages to deprived Evrytanian children. They sent school supplies, flags, globes, and wood stoves for winter. They also sent shoes to poor people and even a prosthetic limb for a young woman who had lost her leg. Even a fund was raised for poor girls' dowry. After the reconstruction of the Hospital of Evrytania, they helped with its furnishing and support.
Beginning in 1980, the daughters started forming their first chapters, following the example of Velouchi. Currently, there are 9 chapters. Members and donations have increased from local events organized by each chapter. For example, Charlotte's chapter alone, following the huge success of their annual projects, donated $10,000 for charity and scholarships. Also, the Winston-Salem chapter financed the installation of bells for the small church of Carpenisi's nursing home. Some of the most important works were carried out at the Panagia Prusiotissa Chapel in Charlotte. Along with support for the orphanage of Lamia, the creation of a mobile soup kitchen in Carpenisi, heating at schools, scholarships for young girls, and financing for women's dental coverage in Evrytania.
Every year, and with considerable foresight, they collect money for a future nursing home in America. The only income for this comes from the annual raffle and subscriptions. Donations and charitable gifts now total in the hundreds of thousands of dollars. Generosity, companionship, and love for the homeland are the backbone of existence for the Daughters of Evrytania.
I'd like to introduce Mrs. Laura Nixon, past president of the Daughters of Evrytania and past secretary of the Velouchi Association. Please tell us about the Daughters of Evrytania and its role in the Velouchi.
Thank you. The daughters have faced many challenges over the past 68 years, but as past president, I have been excited to watch this beautiful organization continue the spirit of support and in providing for the poor. Our young women are inspired by the sacrificial dedication of their predecessors, and we encourage them to continue the great work of the daughters. Hand in hand, the Velouchi and the daughters will look forward to arriving at their 75th anniversary, just 5 years away, and achieving even greater accomplishments. We encourage and support our young people to become active members that will carry us on to greater heights.
It was under the presidency of Georgios Dais in 1993 and during the annual convention of the association when the General Assembly decided that the Daughters of Evrytania would have the right to register as equal members of the Velouchi Association. Our Evrytanian youth is the present and future of the association. Active since 1970 and officially organized since 1991, it consists of conscientious young people who are proud of their Evrytanian origin and aim to take over and continue the great work of the association. Our young people with Athanasios Kenderis, former president of the association, Kostas Siokis, Dr. Dimitrios Kotsianas and Elisabeth Kazaku playing the leading parts, have already organized the last 3 annual conventions of the association. Dimitris Kondos and Dimitris Georgiou, as heads of the association's Information Technology and Communication Committee, are already active and exploit the full potential of the new technology at the headquarters for modern and more effective communication.
A key role in the organization of our youth was played by Stavros Trastelis and Seraphim Balatsas, both of whom were elected presidents of the association at a young age. Also important are the contributions of Athanasios Nikopoulos, Dr. Apostolos Dallas, Christos Karigiorgis, Ioanna Mandi Katsanu, Dionysios Kastritsis, Dina Fotopoulou Apostolopoulou, and Ioannis Cortesis. Many young people of our association have already taken over the presidency of different chapters, while they also play an active role as members of various committees of the association.
Παλιά λέγαμε ότι η νεολαία ήταν το μέλλον της ενώσεως, αλλά η αλήθεια είναι ότι είναι η καρδιά και η ψυχή σήμερα του Βελούχη. Και πώς μπορούμε να τραβήξουμε την νεολαία και να την κρατήσουμε πιο κοντά μας, πρέπει να τους δίνουμε πρωτοβουλίες, να υποστηρίζουμε τις προσπάθειές τους και όσο πιο δυνατό. Και έτσι μπορούμε να κρατήσουμε την νεολαία και να δυναμώσουμε και την ένωση.
Μαζί μας η Τίνα Φωτοπούλου Αποστολοπούλου, πρώην πρόεδρος της νεολαίας της Ένωσης. Τίνα, ποια είναι η εμπειρία σας από την συμμετοχή σας στην Ένωση?
Η συμμετοχή μου στο Συμβούλιο των Νέων ήταν για μένα μια μοναδική και εξαιρετική εμπειρία, διότι είχα την ευκαιρία να γνωρίσω πολλούς νέους Ευρετάνες, με τους οποίους συνεργάστηκα και προσφέραμε στο έργο του Βιλοχιού. Το μήνυμά μου για τους νέους είναι να συμμετάσχουν ενεργά, να προσφέρουν και να συμβάλλουν και οι ίδιοι στο αξιόλογο έργο της Ένωσης.
The purchase of the impressive building for the association's headquarters took place in 1972 for the amount of $230,000 upon the suggestions and actions of the former president of the association, Stavros Nikopoulos, and under the presidency of Panayotis Klitsis and Georgios Sipsis. The building also provides the association with a stable rental income of more than $70,000 per year.
Είμαι πολύ υπερήφανος που επί 37 συνεχή χρόνια υπηρετώ στο Εθνικό Συμβούλιο της Ενώσεώς μας ως γραμματέας για τα 7 πρώτα χρόνια και ως ταμείας τα τελευταία 30. Εγκάρδιες ευχαριστήσεις σε όλους τους Προέδρους και τα μέλη των Διοικητικών Συμβουλίων της Ιστορικής μας Ένωσης που είχα τη χαρά να συνεργαστώ μαζί τους, αλλά και σε όλα τα μέλη μας που με τίμησαν και με εμπιστεύθηκαν να τους υπηρετώ όλα αυτά τα χρόνια. Πάντα υγεία.
Είμαστε υπερήφανοι για την ένωσή μας Ευρυτάνων Αμερικής στο Βελούχι. Σεμινόμενοι, αλλά και με υπερηφάνεια αναφέρουμε ότι επί προεδρίας της συζύγου μου Γιούλας και μου ιδρύθηκαν τα πρώτα 4 τμήματα του Βελοχιού και τα πρώτα τμήματα των θυγατέρων Ευρυτανίας. Έχουμε τώρα 18 τμήματα σε όλη την ανατολική ακτή των Ηνωμένων Πολιτειών Αμερικής, πράγμα που κάνει την ενωσή μας εθνική οργάνωση που ενώνει όλους τους Ευρυτάνους Αμερικής και την κάνει ακόμη πιο αποτελεσματική. Είμαστε λοιπόν υπερήφανοι για το τι έχουμε κατορθώσει ως Ευρυτάνες
The association, before the establishment of chapters in cities with a strong presence of Evrytanians, used to have representatives to provide better service to the members and communication with headquarters. Upon the initiative and action of Andreas Kambazionis, who was then the president of the association, 4 chapters were established in 1973, the first of which was chapter number 1, Panagia Prusiotissa in Florence. Since then, and thanks to our compatriots' tireless help, 18 chapters have been established, mostly all over the East Coast of the United States of America. A telling example of patriotism are the efforts of our compatriot Dimitris Karadimitris, the founder of the 17th chapter OAETOS in Atlanta and president for a whole decade. Taking action himself and with the blessing of Metropolitan Alexios, he visited the Prusos Monastery in Evrytania, and received an exact copy of the miraculous icon of Panagia Prusiotissa. After it was painted by a professional icon painter, he brought the icon to the USA, where it is now permanently located in the chapel of the metropolis of Atlanta.
The newest chapter of the association was founded in 2005 in New Cumberland upon the initiative of the then president Spiros Papaioannou and current president of the association Ioannis Peslis. This structure helped the Evrytanian Association of America Velouchi become the largest and among the most active and leading organizations of the Greek diaspora worldwide.
The charity foundation of the association was established in 1983. Initiator and first president of the foundation was Judge Spiros Skenderis. In 1986, Maria Tsiamtsouri from Gorianades of Evrytania originally donated $45,000 to the foundation. Also, a donation of $6,500 was made by Pete Harris, and $5,000 were donated by the association. In addition, the foundation receives money from various sources and now manages the amount of $400,000 in performing its excellent charitable work. Presidents of the foundation include Christos Moutos, followed by Minas Daskalakis, Yorios Sipsis, Dr. Apostolos Dallas, Vasilios Fallis, Athanasios Nikopoulos, Konstantinos Barlas, Christos Karayorgos, and current president Nikos Apostolopoulos.
Every year, an organizing committee is appointed, the primary responsibility of which is the proper preparation and best possible conduct of the conventions. The conventions take place each year at the end of June in cities where chapters of the association exist, as well as in other cities of the USA that may show interest. For many years, Judge and State Representative Ioannis Agelis, being in charge of the General Assemblies and Conventions, played a critical role in their success. With his boundless sense of humor, his insight and clarity of thought, he set the model for future conventions. Equally effective as presidents of the General Assemblies and Conventions were Haralambos Yogas, Georgios Kanavos, Stavros Trastelis, and Andreas Kabizionis.
A General Assembly is conducted along with a convention, and it constitutes the supreme body of the association. It includes the annual report describing the association's activities, new proposals, resolutions, and final decisions. Every year, our compatriots meet at the conventions of the association, during which new friendships are made, older ones are renewed, while relatives meet with one another. They also provide a chance for young people to meet, as the association tries to pass on to them our culture, as well as our customs and traditions. The annual banquet dinners also play an important role, as they mark the end of the work of every convention. During these dinners, students of the association with the highest academic performance are awarded with scholarships, acknowledgments are made, and honorary plaques are awarded to members with the greatest activity and performance, while all honorary guests share their greetings. The participation of the members and friends of the association, and the diaspora in general, at the three-day events is massive, and these social events are of interest not only to Evrytanians, but to the whole Greek diaspora. Each convention is an authentic celebration of Roumeli and much more.
During the annual convention, our youth distinguish themselves in basketball. Teams from different areas where chapters of the association exist get prepared and play each other for the championship. Also interesting is the golf championship between teams from different chapters to determine the best team.
Over time, the association has welcomed, hosted, and promoted priests, politicians, and other personalities from Greece and America. Its annual conventions are always honored by the presence of representatives of the metropolis of Atlanta and Karpenisi, as well as representatives of the authorities of the Evrytania Prefecture, such as ministers, members of the parliament, prefects, mayors, and other local officials. Also attending the conventions of the association are representatives of the Greek embassy and the Greek consulates in America, as well as officials of the authorities in the states where conventions are held. The presence of those institutional actors at our conventions gives us the opportunity to showcase our work, to strengthen our relations, and to discuss issues concerning the association and the diaspora in general.
The conventions held in Evrytania have been milestones in the development and progress of the association. The 32nd convention was held July 19th to 24th, 1976, in Karpenisi, under the auspices of the former President of our Republic and compatriot, Konstantinos Tsatsos, and under the presidency of Dr. Georgios Kanavos. The program of the aforementioned convention included, among other things, an official welcome at Athens Airport with the presence of Deputy Minister Chrysostomos Karapiperis and Evrytanians Member of the Parliament Konstantinos Papaspiros, as well as a wreath-laying ceremony at the Monument of the Unknown Soldier in front of the Parliament in Athens. An equivalent welcoming ceremony had also been prepared for the conventioners by the provincial and municipal authorities in Karpenisi, first with praise to God from the Metropolitan of Karpenisi, followed by a wreath-laying ceremony at Marcos Botzeris Monument. Also, after the ceremony which unveiled the statue of Katsandonis, a wreath was laid on behalf of the association. The program for the official welcome of the conventioners ended with dances in the central square and Kefalovriso, banquet dinners and a pilgrimage to the Prusiotissa and Tatarna monasteries.
Also remarkable was the 42nd convention in 1986, held in Karpenisi, under the presidency of the late Konstantinos Balafas. The welcoming of the conventioners was made more impressive by the participation of local authorities. Equally important and historic was the 45th convention of the association in Karpenisi in 1989, under the presidency of Stavros Trastelis. Speeches and greetings were given by, among others, Metropolitan Nikolaos of Karpenisi, Evrytania's Member of Parliament, Pavlos Bakoyanis, while the President of the Association gave an in-depth and revealing speech on issues concerning our homeland's development and, more generally, production.
The golden 50th anniversary of the Association was highly celebrated in Charlotte, North Carolina, from the 24th to the 26th of June 1994. During the three-day celebration, many impressive events took place, such as a review of the history of our association, rich as it is in goals and achievements, and the acknowledgement of the work of its founders and former presidents. Also, the most significant benefactors of the association were acknowledged, and some members were honored for their exceptional contributions to the purposes and works of the association. Also, among the guest speakers was the president of the 50th convention, Ioannis Aguilis, Athanasios and Eleftheria Nikopoulou, presidents of the association and daughters of Evrytania respectively, and the vice president of the association, Andreas Apostolopoulos, who presented the families of the founders.
Also, during this great symposium, the contribution of three members who had participated in the first convention of the association was acknowledged, namely Kostas Balafas, Dimitris Panopoulos, and Athanasios Bakatsias. In addition, Thomas Cavallaris, Kostas Balafas, Xenophondas Nikopoulos, Dimitrios Polizos, and Yorgos Sipsis were acknowledged for their important contributions to the progress and development of the association's plans. Bishop Philippos, Ioannis Angelis, and Panayotis Kostopanayotis received honorary plaques in recognition of their contributions. Responsible for the organization and extraordinary success of this anniversary were Athanasios and Eleftherio Nikopoulou, Nikos Apostolopoulos, Athanasios Papaspirou, as well as Nikolaos Kondonikas, who was the head of the symposium, along with his wife Olga. After the completion of the celebration of 50 golden years, the fourth commemorative album of the association was written and printed, a project accomplished by Athanasios and Eleftheria Nikopoulou and Olga Kondonika. A bright example of beneficence towards the association was provided by Ioannis Nitsios from Eastern Frangista of Evrytania, who donated to the association in the 1950s a plot of land located in Destin, Northwest Florida, which he named Frangista Beach in honor of his village. In 1996, during a special general assembly, the association decided to sell this property for $350,000. As a small token of its gratitude, the association placed a bust of the benefactor in the central square of his village. It is also worth mentioning Konstantinos Barlas and Georgios Sipsis for the time and effort they put in over several years, watching the commercial development of the area in order to calculate the market value of the property.
The association, deeply and firmly believing in the effectiveness of cooperation and the power of team effort when great issues arose, and always aiming at the best possible result, did not hesitate, and will not hesitate again if needed, to join forces with the local and central administration and with associations and organizations of our special homeland Evrytania and Rumeli in general. In this context, the association has worked at times with the Pan-Evrytanian Union, the Federation of Evrytanian Associations, with the Educational Association of Karpenisi, the Evrytanian Scientists Society, the Central Greece Federation, the Evrytanian Association of America Karpenisi, and the Association of America Panagia Prusiotissa. Prominent compatriots, moved by the tremendous efforts of the association, participated in the conventions, and some of them have written articles praising its work in various prestigious publications, newspapers and magazines, expressing their love and general feeling. It is also worth mentioning Panagiotis Kostopanagiotis's book Prosfora Agapis Pros Tin Enosi, A Gift of Love to the Association. The association feels the need to thank all associations for their excellent collaboration and all those who honored the association by writing about its work.
The contribution of the association's representatives in Greece plays an important role in the implementation of the charitable and educational programs of the association in Evrytania and Greece in general. Over time, the protagonists of this project have included our remarkable compatriots, the director of the Ministry of Education, Athanasios Papakonstantinou, to whom the Velouchi Association owes much of the success of the objectives of that era, and particularly the building of the Hospital of Karpenisi. Also to Panayotis Kostopanayotis, to Vasilios Goulas, Dr. Takis Mathes, Nikolaos Angelis, Pandalis Vlakos, Vasilios Trichias, Ioannis Zumbos, current president, University Professor Ioannis Ifandopoulos, and Kostas Avrambos, who set an example with his contributions and hospitality. Also worthy of praise is the work of Pandalis Vlachos, member of the Representatives Committee and former president of the association, for a project he's been working on for many years in his homeland. Also important is the representation of the association in Australia by Dimitris Danas, who has been tireless in his praise of and contribution to the association.
The Velouchi Bulletin of the Association, which has been regularly issued since 1946, has received universal recognition and numerous awards. The contribution of our immigrant brothers is substantial. Just as huge is the effort of those involved with its successful release. Among them are Dimitrios Polizos, his daughter Olga Kondonika, Seraphim Nikopoulos, Xenophon Nikopoulos, Dimitrios Kastritsis, Alekos Bitsikonakis, and over the last decade, Eleftherios Peroulas.
particular importance was the program for the collection of money and clothing, which contributed to the relief of our Evrytanian compatriots from the ravages of World War II. The same program was later repeated when the homeland experienced the suffering of the Civil War. The successful accomplishment of such a sacred and challenging purpose was made possible and reached the highest level of success thanks to the dynamic organization of the members of the association. The association, since its establishment, has contributed significantly to the sending of antibiotics, clothing, and food to Evrytania.
The building of the Hospital of Karpenisi, following a request by many generations of Evrytanians, constitutes the most important work of the association. Evrytanians needed medical care as well as the possibility for direct treatment of patients by a well-organized and equipped hospital in their local area. It provided direct aid to small or more serious cases that needed urgent treatment. Works for the reconstruction of the Hospital of Karpenisi began in 1951, thanks to the Evrytanians of America, who showed great interest and love for our fellow men. It was entirely funded by fundraising efforts of the members of the association, and it was completed in 1953. Since then, the operation and management of the General Hospital of Karpenisi has become responsibility of the Greek state.
After the coordinated actions of the presidents of the Committees of Public Relations and Representation in Greece on renaming the original stone building of the hospital to Pteriga της Ένωσης, Ward of the Association, the hospital's Board of Trustees unanimously decided on June 20, 2014, to name the new ward of the hospital, Ward of the Evrytanian Association of America, Velouchi, instead of the aforementioned building. This decision is recognition of the association's great contribution.
Important and essential for that period was the charitable work of the Association Velouchi concerning the granting of dowries to poor Evrytanian girls. This program provided an unexpected gift that fulfilled the girls' dreams and helped them start their own families. This particular activity of the association had such great impact that the then King of Greece, Paul, personally handed those bank books to the future brides who lacked a source of income. The association invested more than $20,000 in this program during the 50s.
The soup kitchen program offered significant help in the difficult post-war years by providing meals to students of the boarding school of Keresochori. This program began in 1956 and continued successfully for about 20 years.
The most important programs of the association is the granting of scholarships and financial assistance to Evrytanian students in Greece and America on the basis of academic excellence and insufficient financial resources. More than $1 million has been allocated to this program since 1962. Andreas Purnaras was the first president of the association scholarship committee in Athens. Evrytanians of America are thankful for his services and fondness towards the association Velouchi. As president of the scholarship committee, he was the inspiration and heart of this institution.
Praise is also due to University Professor Ioannis Ifandopoulos, president of the association's representation in Greece and president of the scholarship committee in Athens, for his significant contribution to the work and goals of the association and the scholarship institution. Also worthy of praise for their long service and contribution to this program are Dr. Georgios Kanavos, Stavros Trastelis, and Dr. Apostolos Dallas, who have all served as presidents of the committee in America.
My name is Joanna Mantis Katsanos. I have grown up in the Velouchi family, as both of my parents were active members of the association. This organization not only unites the Greek Americans whose roots originate in Evrytania, but since its establishment has provided financial aid to those in need in Greece and has awarded many scholarships to students both in the U.S. and in Greece. I congratulate the Velouchi Association on its many accomplishments, as many people's lives have changed for the better. I also encourage the young adults to become active members so that we may continue the efforts of this philanthropic organization.
The association has created and still maintains an academic cooperation with the Hellenic Society Paideia of the University of Connecticut and its founder and president, Dr. Elias Tomazos. This organization allows Evrytanian students in America to continue their studies through summer or annual university programs offered by universities in Greece, and to transfer their credits to the American universities they normally attend. Velouchi and Paideia also offer corresponding scholarships to the Evrytanian students.
Θεωρώ ότι οι ετήσιες υποτροφίες που προσφέρει η Ένωση εδώ και στην Ελλάδα είναι πολύ σημαντικές και θα πρέπει όχι μόνο να τις υποστηρίζουμε, αλλά με κάθε τρόπο να τις προβάλλουμε και να τις αυξάνουμε. Αισθανόμαστε ιδιαίτερα υπερήφανοι διότι εκατοντάδες φοιτητές και σπουδαστές μέχρι σήμερα έχουν επωφεληθεί στις ακαδημαϊκές τους σπουδές από τις υποτροφίες αυτές και άλλα οικονομικά βοηθήματα.
The nursing home, like the hospital of Karpenisi, represents the culmination of the contribution, love, and great interest of the Evrytanians of America towards our compatriots and others as well. The nursing home was an idea inspired by the association in the 1980s, which became reality thanks to a pan-Evrytanian fundraiser in America, which financed the project to the amount of $250,000. The association, in great cooperation with Panayotis Kostopanayotis, then president of Pan-Evrytanian Association, and Georgios Armagos, then president of the Educational Association of Karpenisi, firstly convinced the municipality of Karpenisi to donate the particular land and then the Greek state to assume the house's reconstruction and operation.
Praise for this pious work belongs, of course, to all Evrytanians. Special thanks, however, are due to Evangelos Magyris, who contributed the sum of $10,000 to the joint efforts of the association for the nursing home. Undivided, close, enthusiastic, and above all, essential cooperation was exhibited by the then mayors of Karpenisi, attorney Stelios Lefas, Takis Seretakis, and Dr. Yannis Papadopoulos.
70 years Velouchi has helped the poor, the sick, our seniors, and our students. One of Velouchi's great accomplishments was the idea of establishing a gerocomio in Evrytania. Our seniors in America deserve quality care in a Hellenic atmosphere. Velouchi was instrumental in maintaining old friendships and creating new friendships that last a lifetime. It is our wish that our children and grandchildren will continue with Velouchi's great philanthropic work. My best wishes to all of you.
Velouchi has contributed morally and materially to the establishment of the Roumeli Cultural Center in Athens. There, the Pan-Evrytanian Association, under the presidency of Panayotis Kostopanayotis and with Secretary General Ioannis Zoupos as speaker, honored the 50th anniversary of the Evrytanian Association of America Velouchi. Aside from Evrytanian officials, the event was also attended by other prominent personalities from all over Greece.
One of Velouchi's major successes is the proclamation of the 25th of March as Greek Independence Day by the North Carolina House of Representatives, an effort which was first initiated by Yannis Tsiamis under the presidency of Christos Stathopoulos in the city of Winchester, Virginia. The following year, At the initiative of the former president Andreas Kambizionis, the recognition was repeated, and the proclamation of the 25th of March as Greek Independence Day was officially established in South Carolina as well. The signing of the proclamation took place in a festive atmosphere. A choir sang the national anthems of both countries and the Tin Ipermacho chant, while the flags of the two countries were raised. On his own initiative, a similar proclamation is made each year by the mayor of the city of Florence, South Carolina, with the participation in national costumes of the chapter's members, the community, and the Greek school. Also, on March 16, 1983, the House of Representatives of the state of Tennessee voted and established by law the 25th of March as Greek Independence Day.
Κάθε χρόνο γιορτάζουμε με υπερηφάνεια την εθνική μας ανεξαρτησία. Η 25η Μαρτίου έχει αναγνωριστεί και γιορτάζεται επίσημα από πολλές πολιτείες στην Αμερική ως ημέρα της ελληνικής ανεξαρτησίας, με προκήρυξη των κυβερνητών. Επίσης, έχει αναγνωριστεί και από το Λευκό Οίκο παρουσία αντιπροσώπων της Ιεράς Αρχιεπισκοπής Αμερικής, πράγμα βέβαια το οποίο αποτελεί για όλους εμάς μεγάλη τιμή.
The cooperation between the Pan-Evrytanian Association and the Evrytanian Association of America Velouchi enabled the economic and moral support of the Good Samaritans program, which provided free medical care for decades with home visits of doctors to residents of remote Evrytanian villages.
The local chapter of Velouchi purchased 44 hectares of land at a beautiful site near the city of Charlotte. The effective use of this park is a result of the personal hard work of chapter presidents Konstantinos Bakoyorgos and Evangelos Dimopoulos on the construction of the chapel and the open space for events. Dynamic contributions to this effort also came from brothers Nikolaos and Eleftherios Sitaras, Georgios Tzioros, Alekos Primbas, Georgios Antoniou, Kostas Panou, and Nikolaos Bakatsias. Also significant and valuable is the extension of the chapel and the construction of the social events hall, which took place under the presidency of Athanasios Nikopoulos. He, as a member of the fundraising committee and under the presidency of Ioannis Politis, achieved the impossible. They managed to raise the amount of $650,000 for the aforementioned works, and this fundraiser continues to this day. A great credit is also due to Seraphim Pitsiolis, member of the church committee, and all the women for their years of tireless service at Panagia Prusiotisa Chapel. And to Seraphim Nikopoulos for his services in the Eletos Park. It would be an omission not to mention the enormous and priceless contribution of Dimitrios Kastritsis, who served on various posts of the association and chapter for more than 30 years.
Αγαπητοί μας, είμαι ο πατήρ ταξιάρχης Βλάχος, κατάγομαι από το στένομα της Ευρυτανίας, υπηρέτησα στον Ιερό Καθεδρικό Ναό της Αγίας Τριάδος του Σάρλοτ, Βορείας Καρολίνας, για πλέον από 30 χρόνια. Είμαι μέλος του συλλόγου μας και υποστηρίζω το σύλλογο όσο μπορώ περισσότερο. Ο σκοπός του συλλόγου μας είναι να κρατήσουμε ζωντανά και στη χώρα αυτή που ζούμε την ορθόδοξη πίστη μας, τη γλώσσα μας και τα ήθη και έθιμα του ελληνισμού. Να διατηρήσουμε την ένωση του συλλόγου μας, να αποφεύγουμε τις έχθρες αναμεταξύ μας και να τις γράφουμε στο νερό για να εξαφανίζονται αμέσως.
The association, with the concerted actions of Dimitris Karadimitris, then president of the 17th chapter Oaetos of Atlanta, contributed the sum of $5,000 to the initiative of AHEPA and other Philhellenes for the building of the Olympic Park statue, a present to the city of Atlanta and tribute to the centenary of the Olympic Games.
protection and support offered to children with special needs in Evrytania is one of the most important programs of the association. Supporting those children is not just an obligation, it is a charitable act showing great sensitivity. This work of love and care for children with special needs was adopted under the presidency of Nikos Apostolopoulos at the association's annual convention in 1997. The next elected president, Christos Stathopoulos, immediately undertook its implementation. The program continues to this day with great success. Finally, Athanasios Nikopoulos has also contributed to this effort.
Undivided interest in the implementation of the program was also shown by the Director of Social Welfare in Evrytania, Areti Kehribari, the then Prefect Dimosthenis Tsiamakis, as well as Vasilis Goulas, President of the Representation in Greece Committee. The funding of the program was initiated by a donation of $5,000 from Ioannis Politis and continued with contributions from the association and its chapters. Also important are the personal contributions from members and the annual fundraiser's outcome. The participants of the program deserve congratulations.
During the 60th convention in 2004, under the presidency of Spiros Papayioannou, the General Assembly adopted the comprehensive proposal of Nikos Apostolopoulos, which provided a 5-year plan for the raising of $100,000 for the Metropolis of Atlanta, the Ekonia Center. It is a magnificent Hellenic Christian center for multiple uses in the mountainous area of South Carolina, which hosts and serves the 74 Greek communities of the Metropolis of Atlanta, and of which our association is particularly proud.
The raffle, which started in 2004, brings earnings of more than $40,000 annually, all of which are allocated to the scholarship program of the association. Every year, the Board of Trustees appoints a committee responsible for the sale of the tickets. The success of this program is due to the committee's hard work, the mobilization of its chapters, and generally the involvement of the members of the association. The raffle program began in 2004 at the initiative of Spiros Papayioannou and Nikos Apostolopoulos.
In 2004, with the initiative and hard work of the vigorous members of the Asheville chapter, and especially thanks to the efforts of Andreas Apostolopoulos and Paulina Kaltsouni Vastaki, as well as the deputy mayor of Karpenisi, Leonidas Papadopoulos, Rodothea Karfi, and Stavros Siaksambanis, the vision of twinning the mountainous towns of Karpenisi and Asheville became reality.
During the presidency of Serafim Nikopoulos, the generous members and friends of the association raised the amount of $25,000, which was allocated by the president of the representative committee in Greece, Professor Ioannis Ifandopoulos, to supply the region's fire-ravaged schools with computers and essential teaching materials. A great success of the association was the organization of the visit pilgrimage of around 100 of our members to the Ecumenical Patriarchate of Constantinople. The excursion was organized by Nikos Apostolopoulos, Kostas Kazakos and Spiros Papayioannou under the auspices of Metropolitan Alexios of Atlanta. Another success was the financial assistance from the members' fundraiser, as well as the guided visit and hosting.
From time to time, the association has deservedly been given awards and recognitions. Most importantly, the Grand Cross of the Savior, Megalosthavros του Sotiros, by the Greek government for the establishment of the Karpenisi Hospital, the Athens Academy Award for the numerous charitable activities of the association. The recognition in Rome, Italy, in 1970 of the association's press release, Velouchi, as one of the best publications among charitable organizations. The St. Paul Archbishop Medal for Charity and Social Work. And the honorary recognition by the former president of Greece, Kostis Stephanopoulos, of the association's Solidarity Program.
The creation of the historical documentary of the association gave its members the opportunity to participate in a ceremonial event with photographs and personal interviews. The ceremony was held on May 22, 2011, right after the Divine Liturgy at the Community Center of the Holy Trinity Cathedral in Charlotte. Given the lack of time during banquets at the conventions, the Board of Trustees approved on this occasion the awarding of honors and public recognitions as well as the awarding of plaques to former presidents and other members for their long and invaluable services. Responsible for the organization and conduct of the event were Nikos Apostolopoulos and Eleftherios Peroulas, while the awarding of plaques was made by Athanasios Kenderis and Eleftheria Nikopoulou, former president and former secretary of the association, respectively. The scientific conference entitled Achievements of the Evrytanian Diaspora was organized in Karpenisi on October 18th and 19th, 2012, and in Keresohori of Agrafa on October 20th, 2012, at the initiative of University Professor Kleomenis Koutsoukis. Our association, which sponsored this conference, had prepared a speech on the history and achievements of the Evrytanian Association Velouchi and Diaspora Today, and also participated at the Presidium. It has been characterized as one of the best conferences, with strong participation and significant success in the topics discussed during its three-day program. The association is very proud that its members help and support, morally and financially, the Socrates Academy, a charter public school of Greek interests that began its operation in 2005 with the initiative of the secretary of the association, Eleftherios Peroulas. At first having 67 students in kindergarten and first grade, it has now developed into an integrated elementary and high school with 650 students and 500 other outstanding applications. The state of North Carolina, recognizing the multilingual and multicultural educational success of the school, has conferred on it for four consecutive years now, the top educational recognition of Honors School of Excellence with High Growth, awarded to top public schools.
Μαζί μας ο κύριος Ελευθέριος Περούλας. Κύριε Περούλα, πέστε μας για την συμβολή των Ευρετάνων στην ελληνική παιδεία.
Βεβαίως. Θέλω να εκφράσω την ευγνωμοσύνη και τα θερμά μου συγχαρητήρια σε όλα εκείνα τα μέλη της Ένωσης που αγκάλιασαν τις προσπάθειες που γίνονται για τη διατήρηση, καλλιέργεια και προαγωγή της ελληνικής παιδείας και της ελληνοχριστιανικής μας κληρονομιάς στα δύο ελληνικά σχολεία, το Απογευματινό Σχολείο Αγίας Τριάδας και το Ημερήσιο Δημόσιο Σχολείο Ακαδημία Σωκράτη. Η αγάπη τους και η οικονομική τους δέσμευση στην εκπλήρωση των εκπαιδευτικών σκοπών της Ένωσης αποτελούν για μας όλους παράδειγμα προς μίμηση. Η ελληνική παιδεία θα ήταν πολύ φτωχότερη σήμερα στην Σάρωτ χωρίς τους Ευρυτάνες της Ένωσης και δεν θα ήταν αυτό που όλοι μας θεωρούμε σήμερα προπήγιο της ελληνικής παιδείας.
Following the concerted efforts of the Public Relations Committee of the Association, Vice Regional Governor Vasilis Karambas notified the chairmanship of Velouchi in writing of his decision, according to which the association would be included in the list of bodies to lay a wreath on national days at the Monument of the Unknown Soldier on behalf of the Evrytanian diaspora.
Our renowned members have generously extended their contribution to the association beyond the promotion of the association's work to another equally important work with cultural and patriotic importance. Our compatriots Dimitrios and Eleni Tasiou undertook at their own cost the creation of a statue of Marcos Botzaris, hero of 1821, who sacrificed himself for the freedom of our country, leaving his last breath in the Battle of Kefalovriso in Evrytania, south of Karpenisi. The statue of Marcos Botzaris was recently erected at the National Military Museum of Athens. They also financed the construction of the Statue of Liberty at the entrance of the holy city of Mesologi. Our association warmly thanked and congratulated Dimitrios and Eleni Tasiou for their selfless and remarkable offer.
Devoted Evrytanians, wishing to maintain and pass on the history and work of the association, the values and traditions of our people and homeland to the younger generations have generously contributed a significant sum to cover the costs of production of this DVD, which will be offered free of charge to the members of the association. The association would like to thank those who helped in creating this documentary, and especially all sponsors.
ψηλό, με τα ψηλά σε λάτια που πορές δε σε σκιάζουνε, ούτε βοριά γυνάτια. Velouchi mou grame geno. Vre ke karte erisna Come.